Hey, it's Clay, and this will be a video chart on ticker symbol CYCC. We will take a look at the 30-minute time frame. Real quick, what do I mean by 30-minute in case maybe you're new to charts? Instead of each one of these candlesticks here representing one day's worth of price action, which is what you would normally see, each one represents 30 minutes. So while this here may look like several days' worth of time, it's actually today's price action broken down into 30-minute time slices. I like to do this time frame, and it's a good job of telling the quote-unquote story of the price, and then makes mapping out our levels of support and resistance a bit easier to see. And in this situation, makes summarizing the price movement very straightforward. So keep in mind, this next statement, I'm referring to the price action, how the price is acted. I don't know anything about the company, so this is not directed at the company. But as far as how the price acted today, an absolute pump and dump. You could use the term gap and trap too. But regardless, it was a great gap up. I mean, there's no doubt about it. I mean, so how would this a dump, pump and dump? Well, let's go with the first part of the pump. Well, the price made a great move. I mean, when you consider that it closed there on Thursday and then all of a sudden opened all the way up there today on Friday, I think we can all agree that was a really great move. Then the next part of a pump and dump is within a relatively short amount of time. Considering this all happened in the exact same day, I'm hoping we can agree that this did indeed happen in a very short amount of time. And then the final part of the definition is the price just goes back to where it started, or in some cases lower. Think about it. Where did it start? It started right here. Where did it actually close today? Way lower than where it even started. So that is the epitome of a pump and dump. Now, with all that being said, am I saying the price can never make another nice move upwards? I'm not saying that at all. In fact, if you've traded long enough, I'm sure you've seen plenty of setups like this where there is a pump and dump from a price action point of view, and then there's some nice bounce back. Now, does that guarantee that there's going to be a good solid bounce back next week? I only wish that there is a such thing as a guarantee in the market. But is it logical to at least think that there could potentially be? Sure, especially in this case, when the price has very clearly started to level out, which brings about the initial area of support to keep an eye on going into next week, which is that 78 cent mark. Now, if the price goes down there and crashes through 78, just to get a little bit of perspective here, that is going to start to put the price even lower than where it's been for literally several weeks. So 78 is without doubt the must hold level for, nothing complicated other than the fact that if the price breaks below there and then just continues to separate to the downside, I mean, that's literally putting the price into a range that it hasn't seen for a very long time. In the event there is a bounce to the upside, initial area of resistance is going to be that pink line there. The 200 period moving average right now valued at 83 cents. Next level going to be that purple line, the 50 period moving average, and that is currently valued at 86 cents. So we'll see if the bulls can get some sort of snapback reaction next week or not. One of the biggest questions I get is, hey Clay, how do you find the stocks that you trade? So what I've done is put together a free resource guide where I talk about the tools that I use to locate stocks that I find interesting and think may have potential. So if that sounds like something that could add value to you as a trader, then click on the image that is up on the screen right now and I will email you the guide. The guide itself is very short and to the point, and best part, it's completely free. Thanks for watching the video. Let me know if you have any questions.